University Tirupati in 1987, MS in General Surgery at Dr. NTR University of Health Sciences, Vijayawada in 1992, MTech Cardiothoracic and Vascular Surgery at Dr. NTR University, Vijayawada, Andhra Pradesh. He actually played important role in establishment of ICUs in government medical colleges in Andhra Pradesh. He conducted 125 open heart surgeries successfully in a span of 1 year as single on-duty cardiac surgeon. He's a disciplined and confident surgeon who strives to provide state-of-the-art healthcare at an affordable cost to the public sector. He has an extensive experience in the field of CTVS surgery and has conducted more than 4,000 surgeries in his career. With a vision of making a million hearts smile, Dr. Reddy received Best Doctor Award by Andhra Pradesh State Government on Independence Day in 2004 and again in 2017. Dr. Reddy, please.
Respected dignitaries on the dais and of the dais, first I will thankful to the organizers who have given this opportunity to speak in this session. From morning, we are seeing the brainstorming sessions and stalwarts are there in the science. They have delivered a lot of lectures and we discussed about the whether God is there or not, or science is there, and so many things we have discussed. But my topic is on medical ethics. So before talking of the ethics, what is most of the people, they believe in God. So why, what is God? God is nothing but a help. So whatever if you take from all Vedas, Upanishads, everywhere, in every country, in every societies, wherever a help has achieved by a person or got that person, that will be called as a God. So we call the fish as a God, we called lion as a God, we called Rama as a God, the Egyptian called Jackal is a God. So like that, everybody, wherever they got some help, it is called God. So God is nothing but a help, I believe it. So that's why sometimes doctors also called as a God, but they are not gods. The help the persons are receiving, that will be called as a God. So from, we know we are all science students, and from unicellular organisms to the multicellular organisms as a Homo sapiens, we all having a basic need. One is diet, that is a nutrition. Second is reproduction, that is the cell's function. So if you want these two, the nutrition and reproduction, we need a good health. So for that health, in a large way, that is a medical science. So for this, these fruits of the medical research, suppose from morning sessions, how to you become a good scientist, we thought. So suppose, assume you are all become a good scientist, you are having a good ethics, and you have invented a new things, and at the last level, or the last step, what is happening in the society? You have invented a new thing, and you brought to the thing, to the public, and whether it is reaching to the common man. Suppose if you invent a cell phone, if it is a more than 3 lakhs a cell phone, it is not coming to a normal man. What is the need of invention? What we achieved by inventing this technology? So like that, anything we are inventing, that will reach us to the common man or not. So that is our topic now, that our fruits of medical research, when will reach the common man in the scenario of violated medical ethics. So we formed certain norms in the society. So doctor should be like this, scientist should be like this. Like that we put some norms and we expect from them whether that was followed or not. That we discuss now. So the medical ethics, so the slide projects, a physician shall uphold the dignity and honor of his profession. The prime object of the medical profession is to render the service to the humanity. Reward or financial gains is a subordinate consideration, and he shall keep himself pure in character and diligent in caring for the sick. He should be modest, sober, patient, prompt in discharging his duty without anxiety. The next, a physician should expose without fear or favor incompetent or corrupt, dishonest or unethical conduct on the part of the members of the profession. This means if anybody or colleague has done a grave mistake, he should be courageous to expose his faults and bring goodness to the society. How many people now dare to expose his deficiency or any his fault? Nobody will expose his faults, because if you do that, that society will corner you and they will say that you are not having a ethics. Next, a physician may patent his surgical instruments and appliances and medicines. He copyright his applications. But when it is unethical, if it is in large interest, it should be available in a situation where the interest of the large population involved, it should be available to all, even though it is a patented or is intellectual property. So the first speaker told. So these are the few medical ethics. There are a lot of medical ethics, but to sample I told. But is it followed? You question yourself. It is not at all, most of the times is not followed. A physician or a doctor is a part of the society, and all evil effects of the human beings are rested and nested in his mind. So a physician cannot be separated from the society. He is your son, your brother, your father, your mother, your own kith and kin become a physician, and you have given a milk from his womb and taught so many medical ethics. But once he became a person and grown up, he became a scientist, and when he is administering to the person, he is not following the ethics. Why? The society is changing him. So what is changing? So the changing society values, the circumstances not allowing that person who is from first standard read all ethics and grown with ethics, but not following the ethics when at the time he is administered. So a person want to become a doctor. He is not becoming a doctor by his choice, because from fifth class we are telling him you become a doctor. So it is a parent choice. The person is becoming a doctor. He is having no passion toward the profession, nothing. From fifth class onwards, he is mugging, and he is reading, and he is going to coaching centers, and he is becoming a doctor. And why parent want to become a doctor? His son or daughter become a good doctor. He should earn money. Nobody will question him. He will earn a lot of money. Nobody want thinking of service. So that's why it is not his choice. It is his parent's choice. He is reading. And we are also at the level of intermediate, where 18 years we are giving entrance and giving to the entrance to the medical colleges. So in a US where he has to study plus two and he has to go for a degree, after that they will judge whether this fellow is compatible to become a medical field or not. Then only he will be admitted. We are not doing, we are just questioning his mugging knowledge and we are giving a seats. So where some people, they are not interested. Some people, there is no service motto, but you want doctor should be in a service motto. So this conflict leads to some people may not be having a service motto, some people may not have a service. So what happens? This ethics also gone by a medical colleges, where government itself starts so many private colleges, where huge capitation fees are collected. So if you say in India, there are 10 times more number of private medical colleges rather than government medical colleges. Every year in any state, suppose in your state also, there are so many medical colleges are opening. So where there is no adequate infrastructure is not there, adequate staff is not there, even though we know it, we are admitting our children into that medical college, paying a huge capitation fees. So when a person studies in this medical colleges with paying huge capitation fees and so many fees, is he ready to do service or he wanted to earn money? So that is a basic problem with the government, not with the people. Next, this commercialization of medical establishments. So next is manufacturing and pharma industry. So manufacturing and pharma industry sector it is a business oriented, not service oriented. So here how much physician is involved, we will see. So there is unethical competition between and unethical measures and standards lead to the unfavorable circumstances where this profession forced it into dark ages. So suppose a Penadur injection, that is called a penicillin, where a previous speaker told, it is discovered by chance. A penicillin injection that will be given for certain heart diseases there. So that penicillin injection, it is a very cheap. It is a 10 rupees. That every month he has to take that 10 rupees injection so that certain heart diseases will not progress. That penicillin injection now is not available in third world countries because its production and its profits are very cheap. That's why that is not in the market. That is not available to our India or Bangladesh or Pakistan or like third world countries. Rather than most of the research, as previous told, most of the research is focused on cancer drugs where first world countries are affected. So research is going on cancer drugs and whatever available, whatever disease available to us, we are not getting the medicines for that. So because this research, everything is on money oriented and they are sponsored by companies. Where there is a money, there the research is going on. That's why we are not getting the proper medicines for a humankind. So everybody is a person. So why don't we manufacture penicillin? We don't manufacture penicillin and there is no alternative drugs for that. So some rheumatic heart disease people, they are suffering because lack of penicillin. Even though huge cry, they are not manufacturing at all. Manufacturings are stopped. So every day, a new cancer drugs are discovering. And there is a term called a patency. So in this patency, what is patency? So certain company makes one drug or a stent or anything. So they will tell, I have discovered this property and this is my intellectual property. So I don't want to sell anyone. I will only sell this product. This is my price. So suppose the product price is 5,000. They are selling at 1 lakh. This for 10 years they have given a patency. They will, because they will tell, we have done invested a lot of money for research. In practical, they are spending only 1.3% for their research. The rest remaining thing are only profits. So in France, there is a study conducted in 2005 to 2014. Around 1032 medicines are discovered. In that only 66 given some results. 177 medicines are not at all safe. They are not safe at all. And because of this patency, what happened? So many drugs come into the market. So many will make money. They will go out of the market. And they will tell you, we are doing a lot of research. What research they are doing, wherever there is a money is there, they will go on research and they will do some products and say, no, this product is bad. They will remove from this. Meanwhile, they will make a market and get it. Even though, as Saumitra Bernard said, there is a double blind studies are there, everything is there. Still, everything runs around the money. Who are running around the money? Our society is running around the money. Scientists are making, even though you have become a good scientist, and developed so many research and detected a products, but when come to a final pathway, then all these coming into our mind. So next is, there is a term called compulsory licensing. So in this compulsory licensing, where certain product is involved for a huge people, Even though patency, we can manufacture it. So in Thailand, in a AIDS, HIV medicine is there. In an emergency, they have manufactured the drug. So that same company went into the market and they told, you remove from this. Otherwise, we won't supply any new drug to the Thailand. So they forced and dictated terms and stopped the drug to be manufactured from that company. To that extent, our egos are going and we are not allowing people to get that medicines to the needy people, even though there is a compulsory licensing method is there. And some Bayer's company, a Nexavar drug was produced and it put that 5 grams drug is 7,80,000. So how this can be purchased by a common man? They are telling, we not made for Indians or third world countries. We made this drug for first world countries only. So that is the research they are telling. So anybody, common man, if you make a Madame Curie, just now told, entire his life spent and detected a radioactive medicine, she told it is not my property. I detected for people. So she has given without patency that technology to all. Now everybody is going to that technology and we are getting the fruits. It was reached very easily. But now, see what Nexavir is not came to India because this very huge margin. And some people we don't want to give to India. And there are other most controversial topic is stents. So everybody, every day, you've seen us TV programs where there is a lot of controversies is going on stents. So everybody has noticed, say 1.5 lakhs was charged for a stent, 2 lakhs charged for a stent, 3 stents, 6 lakhs, how can we afford? You know, huge crying on the people. But what happens, the original manufacturing company, or if you manufacturing cost, it will be a 5,000 to 6,000 for a stent. That was manufactured, that was sold, or that came to the common man for 1.5 lakhs. So these are, and the invest, the development also, it is a industry oriented. So first they developed one stent that will cost you around 30,000. So when the patents is going, that has become a low value, 5,000. Then they develop a second stent, second generation stent that is called cobalt chromium. That has become a 80,000 and 1 lakh. When that price is coming to 30,000, they will introduce a new stent, a third generation stent, which will cost again 1.5 lakhs. So at any time, you will be charged 1.5 lakh and the first generation stents, nobody will put it. They will tell, it is having that problem, it is having this problem. So what stent you want? 1.5 lakh, like that, they will tell. So anybody will afraid and you will ask for a costly stent. So then you will be loosed. So if it is what research we are doing, without any proper research we are introduced into the market, we are generating the money. So this ethics, to whom we should learn? We are telling so many things. But it was not followed. And governments. So what central government has done, after reading all this and huge crime in the society, they put cap on the stent. So whatever stent you want to manufacture and tell in India, it will be only 30,000. More than that, we should not put. So there is a huge cry and a big company told, we won't sell in India. Whether you will sell or not, we won't allow more than 30,000. That central government put a strict rule. So then all companies are selling in India for less than 30,000. Now companies are selling to 15,000 and 10,000 and so stent is selling. So 1.5 year back, each stent is 1.5 lakh. Now each stent is less than 30,000, 25,000. Now it is 15,000 also, we are getting the same cobalt chromium stents and drug eluting stents. That means what happens, this all 10 years, 1.5 lakh from each patient they have taken. Now how they are giving for 15,000? So what happened to ethics in the society? So, but after putting the crap, now what hospitals are doing, No. Stent is 15 lakhs. But for putting that stent, it is a 15 minutes procedure. For putting that stents, we are charging 1.5 lakhs. So again, the cycle has repeated. Still, we are losing 1.5 lakh. For this also, government has to do something. So anyhow, legislation is more powerful where, like that capping, every time the scientists should sit together and stick to monitoring. Otherwise, it cannot reach the common man. So there is a budgets. Everybody will tell, we are not having a budget, we are not having a budget. There is a lot of needed. Sometimes a budget is allotted. Suppose National Health Rural Mission, a government will allot a lot of funds to the state governments. State government will not properly utilize that. So most of the amount they are allotted, 60% of the amount not utilized in a year, it is was unspent and sent back and taken back by a central government. If you given 12,000 crores, if you spend 12,000 crores, next year they will give 60,000 crores. But nobody using the 12,000 crores. We are using only 3,000 crores. And that money also not using in a proper way. So in fast, they want to do it and lapse the budget. They purchase 300 ambulances. They purchase like that. They purchase, they construct 300 places. Like that, they will usually waste the money and correctly they will not focus on what needed to the society. So the primary healthcare system where primary health centers, most of the Indian people living in the rural area, it was not utilized. Why? Because of our fault, our policy makers' fault. So you see, go to the villages, there is no proper housing, there is no proper infrastructure, there is no proper drainage system, lot of mosquitoes are there. In this 2018, still we are dying with a malaria, dengue, swine flu. Means how much backward we are. Still we are telling, we are developed countries, we will give money to the others. We are underdeveloped countries, the people are telling. So where this rheumatic heart disease, where we will get a sore throat and get a heart diseases, we are not getting in a UK, you are not getting in America. But why you are getting? Because we are not having a proper drainage and lavatory facilities. And still, because we are the people of the society, we as a group, we need our health, I told, the food and reproduction. If you want to enjoy this food and reproduction, we need a long life. If you want a long life, you need a good all infrastructures. We are not spending in a village level that money. And primary health centers where people are not having a good delivery facilities, good infrastructure facilities, there is no proper medicines are there. And at the time of malaria, at the time of dengue, at the time of swine flu, we are promoting non-scientific measures. Go and give homeopathic medicines to whole village. So what homeopathic medicine tell? So whatever diseases will come in 3040 also, they are developed medicine now itself. So whatever disease come, they will tell we are having a medicine. So they will give some three sweet goalies and everybody will go and take that, and you feel that I won't get swine flu. You will definitely, whether you take or not, you will get swine flu. And governments are encouraging and giving a budget to distribute that drugs, that homeopathic medicines or non-Ayurvedic medicines to mass scale in the people. That scientific methodology we are not having in our country. So most of the times, we need a super specialty cares. Most of the times, the budget was not spent. So how many hospitals in Calcutta is having a super specialty care available to the public? In the hospitals, how much hygiene, how much ventilators are there, how much ICU specialties are there? Not there. But we are not having a government is not having a money. Lot of money is there. Why they are not spending? If they wanted to spend, there is a lot of plagiarism, lot of misrepresentation, and the lot of bribery, and money is not utilized properly, and we are not getting the facilities. So what happened? The so many research, the scientists, all people brought this knowledge to the society, it was not utilized. What is the fun of we are developing a new technology? Because we are having the money. There is no problem with the money. But our minds are impure. That's why you are not bringing the technology to the common man. So this corporate world, this is all intellectual property became a commodity. So only profits in this corporate world, there is no place for humanity. So I told the help is God. So we are selling, all are selling with a huge margins. There is no place for the humanity. So by this, if you tell, so many things we will teach from our childhood, so many ethics, but we don't follow. So if you don't want to bring the technology to the poor people, how will it will reach us, how, what impact on the society? So you know the heart is most essential organ. If you get a heart attack, the breadwinner of the family will get a heart attack, so he will be collapsed. If that man is collapsed, his family is collapsed, his daughter is collapsed, his son is studying, he will be collapsed. So by seeing all these measures, so everybody will tell ethics, how they will follow, that is important. So by seeing all this, one day I got realized, even though I am having a busy practice in Vizag, I moved to my native place where that hospital carries around 4 districts and 2 crores population on 4 districts. I developed one center, cardiothoracic surgery center there. I personally taken a file to the all ministers. 100 times I went from Kurnool to Hyderabad, 200 kilometers. I nuked table to table and I mobilized a 10 crores money and I developed one cardiothoracic surgery center where the facilities are on par with US. So this is a intensive care unit of 7 beds where one isolation room is there. This facility, when Americans came and seen, this facility is not available in our hospital also, they told. So this is a operation theater, a modular operation theater, where even bacteria was filtered. They for that coating, the green coating we imported from London, where a bacteria will touch us, it will destroy, a silver nitrate will be released and kills that one. When we asked this, they told, is it needed in a government hospital? No, whether it is a government or private, we are having a lot of money in the government. Why should government hospitals should not be there? So we provide the facility. We fought with the government and we brought this new technology to that government hospital. Now, every day we will do 2 operations. In one year, we have done 125 operations. In 2 years, we have done 300 cardiac surgeries, which will cost 4 to 5 lakhs each surgery will be done free of cost, even single paisa. Even the patient is going home, we are giving charges for his bus charges also. We are supported by a team of NTR Vaidhyasewa. And with a compassion, love and passion, what Taittiriya Upanishad tell, even you give money. So, Sriyadeyam, Hriyadeyam, Priyadeyam. Ante, that means, if you want to give something, you give with love, affection. Just you want to give money, just he's a beggar, don't throw him. You give him with love, passion, comfort. Then only that will be a good thing for the society. So this was, so much people are utilized. They are seeing God in me. I am not God, I am doing a help. So in the 60 years after independence, in a government hospital, if somebody has done it, they will also recognize. Nobody has done it. Why? So everybody gone for the profit, but we have done. That's why everybody was recognized. Our government in the 60 years, nobody was given an award in an independence day for a doctor. Every time they will give only for the IAS and officers and police officers. They never given a doctor. First time specially they have given a chief minister award for me. So, why? So, ethics, it should not be taught. It should be practiced. So, your mother not told you unethical. Your father not told you unethical. Now, why you became unethical? So the society itself changed, you become unethical. So if you are in a ethical, so everybody should follow, want to try to follow ethics, 60% the country will change. So in the modern India, because you are the young scientist, you are the people who want to become a research, there is a, so many things is there. So everybody will not support if you want to do, if I want to do this one, nobody was supported. Even I spent 12 lakhs to bring that center, and even I have given everything, every table, but what I dream is came to existence because of my integrity, and I am a strong mind, I want to do this. That's why I have done. Because if you tell so many body, you will tell so many things. But whether you followed or not, so many people will question. So I followed. You also follow. So you follow the ethics, the young generation, you will never be lost. So you should having, I told, the cell function is nutrition and reproduction. So you need food only. You don't need lakhs, crores of the rupees. You should have a containment. If you have a containment, a god will be born in you. That was told by Shankaracharya. There is no god outside. There is god inside. So when a god inside you, that is a help. So if a god inside you, why are you searching? Why are you going to Tirupati? Why are you going to Kali temple or anywhere? You are a Kali. You are a god. So if you put help, you follow the ethics, everybody see a god in you. You only not recognizing God is in you. God is not outside. So that is that science is God. That help is God. If you follow this, our health for all, needy rather than affordability. So everything should be come to a common man. Our research should be need oriented. If you develop some agricultural product, if you develop some science, you will get a cell phone, you will develop a technology that should be affordable, and it should be needy. It should not be based on affordability. Whoever having money, they should not purchase. Whoever having needy, that should go to that person. That is science is needed. That need strong commitment by the society and rooted by a deep ethical values. Then only our society will flourish. Why everybody will call, I want to go to America, I want to go to America. There I have seen, I have studied there, and I went there, I have seen America and Germany. So many ethical values is there. And most of the times, the people living comfortably, because we should have some ethics in our society. I am not telling nobody is having ethics. Everybody is having ethics. Everybody having know it. When the time come, you should follow it. When the time come, I don't follow nobody seeing. And I am tell all people to follow the ethics. Means our country will not progress and we won't be a good human being. Thank you.